Welcome to this another video on Market Talk YouTube channel. Hope today you guys traders managed to make some good profit today. So let's see what's happened today in the market and start with the trading mantra and disclaimer. So normal disclaimer, you have to please take your own trades based on your own ideas. Please do not consider this as a suggestion for trading. It is purely for educational purpose. The trading mantra for the day: do not short when the market gaps down and do not go long when the market gaps up at the open. 90% of time it's a trap for those who enter the market at market open, because no wise traders set up the stage for market open at the time of market open. They dominate, and the professional traders, they dominate the market close. So always remember that this may not hold for remaining 10%, because this the short breakout, long breakout levels, which I mentioned always the levels, is a Lakshman Rekha. When we sustain above that, don't go at the above, don't follow the above rule. The above rule applies only when it is staying below the long breakout, short breakout at the market open. So this one simple rule can save you a lot of time. We will see also how the market today helped us in following the formula, helped us to make money also. So let's go into the important data, the FI data. So FI data, again they are trying to trap by making some squaring of 10,000 contracts of long futures and added almost 16,000 contracts, 17,000 contracts of long puts. So it doesn't look a good picture actually. They are trying to trap because they are building positions slowly. If you see the last 2 weeks almost, they have been keep building positions and they are going for a big move on the downside possibly. So it is a better advice that you be cautious with the long positions, because retailers or the clients are becoming very cool with the low weeks, expecting the market to always go up, and they're building positions, almost 2 lakh contracts in the long puts. They're shorting the puts actually. They're shorting the puts, and there is a big chance that, you see, if they added 40,000 contracts, means they have become very cool to short the puts now. They're not afraid of shorting puts. Even the proprietary traders squared off the positions in the puts. What are the shorts? So the retailer guys who are shorting puts, expecting they can make money by shorting puts now, is going to be trapped. That's what the data tells here. So be cautious. Don't get trapped with long positions. If you are going short also, long whatever, hedge positions is better. You may lose money on the hedge positions, but definitely on the main position, short position, you'll make money. That's what my opinion is. Let us see the charts, what has happened. And regarding this Renko chart setup which I explained on Friday, I think 50% of people do not understand, it seems. So let me just take you through that chart setup also. So this chart setup, now I just added the flavor of Renko also, and how it works also we will see. We will see one by one. So this is the power of 2, original power of 2 in the future setup. So this is a go short setup, where we opened above the previous day high. This is a blind spot, I told you. The price between the go short and the long breakout is the blind spot. So we traded in the blind spot area almost for till mid noon. After that, once we broke this, because here we broken here for some time, but it was inside the cloud. But once we broke here, when we went below the cloud, then the real power shattered. The power of this go short came, and then we started seeing down moves actually. So then McGinley also continued to just trail you. You see here, we never broken the McGinley 20. We tried to manage the complete show below the McGinley 20. Here some moves came for 2-3 candles, but however it was below the Ichimoku cloud. And this is a VWAP. So VWAP till 12 o'clock, it was almost staying near the VWAP. And the big move came here below the VWAP also. And here, this is the point around 130, 140. The power of 2 gave sell signal for Bank Nifty also. So this is a complete setup. We went up below the short breakout also. After breaking this go short, we went below short breakout also, and they went below previous low also, and closed below previous low. Let us see what happened in the Renko setup. So this is another additional confirmation for us to have an idea. This is the one thing I added here, awesome oscillator, which I showed in the normal chart also. This is the additional confirmation for us. So this is a place where we can go very good position for short, 22743, where the top formed. Actually, I told you, like here, this is the resistance formation here, 11653. once we could not sustain above this level, it slide to made a high, lower high, and then slightly higher low, higher high, then started coming down. From here we started making the down move. The setup, everything explained in the Friday's video, please go through that. And this is a midpoint like Bollinger band. Once we cross down here and cutting the lower don't change channel, then the power came here and we could not even cross above this and sustain below this. So tomorrow when the market goes above this and we to sustain here for making the up move on the downside, the first filter, the second filter, and here the awesome oscillator also should go above zero. So this is the level of filters you see, and automatically also there in the Ichimoku cloud also we should go above this level, 22,350 levels, then only we can go for the buying signal. Coming to the Nifty, in case of Nifty, the same way we opened above the long breakout, so there is no way for shorting the Nifty in the morning opening. But however, this is the futures price, the stars, you can do the dotted line, the futures line. It was roaming around this place. What happens here, whenever the price is around the VWAP, don't try to short or long, go long. It is flat. If it is flat, indicates that the market is not, the participants are not adding positions to the Nifty future, what instrument is there. Once it started moving on the trending on up or down, whatever, then the movement starts actually. If you see here, the VWAP starts moving down, it means that the position is getting added at this time. This is the time where position got added, 2 o'clock. This is a 2 minute candle, correct? So 1, 2, just two candles, we saw movement of longs of 520 to almost 450. 120 points move we got in just 2 minutes, no, 4 minutes time. So this is how the power of volumes also plays a lot. Once we could not sustain about the long breakout, then we went below the go short. Immediately we went below this previous low also. So both have formed some almost like a bearish engulfing pattern. Let us see in the Renko setup also. Renko setup, what happened? Renko setup, let me just the Renko setup, if you see here, we made a higher high, higher high, and then we broke here low only. This is a place we broke low, but however the red Renko bars gave us indication that we can short calls. If you're not buying put also, at least you can buy short the calls, 11,550 calls. This is a place. Once you get a top upper don't change channel, this is a place you can safely or comfortably short the call positions. So this is a rejection area. After this, once you start coming down, then you can short your 11,550 call, that's all, 500 call, and keep on shorting the calls. Or this is a place rejection is coming here on the top side, you can buy 11,500 put also and try. What happens here, if something like this, a reversal comes in the short span of time, again a reversal, then the bought put options can be in a trap. So buying put options, this situation, like this situations, buying put option can trap sometimes, but selling call option, less chance of getting trapped, because definitely you'll make some 20-30 points easily in the Nifty. And also we can see that the awesome oscillator gave buy signal here and never went below zero. So this is the point where it went below zero actually. So till the time we want to above the zero, then we can hold our short positions with the hedge always. Hope this Renko setup you are able to understand, and please try to see in detail, because you have to also learn, observe some things and try to make some learning out of you. Coming to the chart setup, so Nifty hourly chart setup, if you see here, this is the bottom, and then we got reversed about this from 16.8%. So we could not sustain above 16.8%. So any below breakout of downside below levels of 186, then it's going to be on the negative side for the Nifty actually. So till the time it is fine, we can possible that again we can look for a breakout on the upside, but looks very less chance that FIs are building up short positions. Once they build enough short positions, currently still they are holding long position for 5,000 contracts, but anytime they can go for big short positions over just 2-3 days time itself. So it is better that we be on the short side and try to make money on the downside when the market comes down. And Bank Nifty, coming to the Bank Nifty is very pathetic situation. Here we could not even cross 38.2% of retracement. After the downfall, retracement could not even 38.2%, before itself we got collapsed. And then now the last saving point is 21,400 level. If we go below 21,400, then it is very difficult to save. And the final this another support is there where we have double bottom. You can tell here double, triple bottom is there. Lot of support is there here on 21,000 level. So 21,000 level is going to be the next big support for the Bank Nifty. So till the time we have to wait for the position, but option pane is indicating that we have very good support at that upper level, and 22,400 is the option pane. We should be trying to go back to that level actually. So because option writers are not afraid actually, 22,400 option writers are there still holding on the positions. Let us go to the setup, Ichimoku cloud setup. So coming to the Ichimoku cloud setup, we saw here the reversal here in Nifty Eichler Fisher, but it has to go above the zero level for confirmation of the reversal of the trend. Because if you see last two times it was a buy and dips, now it's going to be sell and rise possibly. That is one thing. And then if you see here closely in the Nifty, it is a bearish engulfing pattern form, and Tenkan-sen also crossed below Kijun-sen. So it is definitely not a good indication for the up move bulls. Let us see here, but till we don't sustain above 11,550 levels, this is a high. If you see here is a bigger bull bearish engulfing, this is smaller bearish engulfing. It is not a good sign completely. What happened? And here crossing and sustaining above this, earlier the crossing sustaining above this big candle here formed here, which is around 11,794 was the target. Could not sustain, go near that also before itself started collapsing. And now this candle's high is going to be the next target for bulls to make a move. So 11,566 need to be crossed and closed, sustained above this level for any new moves to come in the Nifty in the coming days. Till the time it is in the bearish move only. So now Bank Nifty has completely clearly given up the move on the upside. And here if you see, it is below Tenkan-sen, Kijun. Tenkan-sen also crossed below Kijun-sen, and 23,346 level after above this, the crossing over, then only we can get some good moves. But as of now, bearish engulfing formed here. If you see the high for all these last 4 days, okay, almost every day, every time it is going under, sustaining about 22,500-600 levels, and then started reversing. So it is a very big resistance for Bank Nifty, 22,600-700 levels. So let us see whether it is going to sustain or not in the remaining days, because here also the bottom around 22,200, 2 days it got support, and today we closed slightly 100 points below the support. So maybe possibly it could be a fake support also, fake move also, because however we closed near the day's low. We will see for tomorrow's move what is happening, but as of now the Dow Jones and Singapore Nifty showing some good moves actually. Possible that tomorrow also could be same like a repeat of today's position. So let us wait for that. But however, this Eichler Fisher is giving, looking for a reversal, possibly a reversal pattern, chances are there. So be just keep a note of this position in Eichler Fisher for Bank Nifty. Let us go to the second setup for Nifty Bank Nifty. Nifty slightly closed below the 20-day moving average, slightly below. And the 20-day moving average is to 11,435, and okay, it's almost slightly 5 points above. So to 11,440 is the closing, 5 points above the 20 moving average. It doesn't look very interesting actually, but it is not advisable. At least you should have touched the upper Bollinger band. It is not happening. Arun indicator, Arun up is given to 60, and then still we need to see a crossover. Once we see the crossover, then the good movement on the downside can come. Coming to the Bank Nifty, Bank Nifty could not even touch a 20 moving average before the result, it started collapsing. So technically target should be 20,500 level should be the target for Bank Nifty. But considering the option pain, still we are looking for up move, something retracement on the upside. Even 22,400 is option pain still now in spite of the down move that we saw today. So possibly tomorrow there could be another up move, but we'll see whether there is any reversal coming on the second half of the day. Let us see the third setup for Nifty. So this is the case for Nifty where we can see the reversal coming again, DA plus crossover, DA minus. So it's a reversal now, it's a bullish setup formed. And here the Heikin Ashi candle is still in the green only. Actually the momentum has also increased, and also the setup is giving a bullish signal only. Still, we yet to form a red candle and break this 11,200 levels super trend. Then only we can see some bearish setup for Nifty. Till 11,200 is not broken, we could not see any bearish setup for Nifty as such. Coming to the Bank Nifty, here still red candle is formed. We can tell a doji, long leg doji. Then we possible that we can see some reversal, because long time now we saw almost like 9-10 candles formed red candle for Heikin-Ashi. Possible that we can, because the momentum is not increasing actually. Open equal to high is not forming. So there is a chance that we could see some reversal also, possibilities there, because everybody is becoming bearish. Now the market want to pull everybody who is bullish, everybody who is bearish into bullish mode, and then only market is going to reverse. That's what I am expecting. So we'll see only three setups. We are not going to see more setups, because many traders are messaging me that they are getting confused, so many setups and all, because there is market, you get so many options available in the market actually, technicals. So but we need to use to understand what is right, what is good, what is bad. We have to filter it out. So well, I'm just filtering to only three options actually. Three setups, three candle setups and three indicators, that's it, nothing more, so that you don't be confused on that. Let's move on to the setup charts, key data. So coming to the key data, both are bearish. PCR is indicating it is we are below one, it is bearish, and but however Bank Nifty showing the 0.59, possible that it is oversold. It is now oversold near 0.5, definitely is oversold zone. So it is not advisable to go short at this point of time, considering the option pane also and the PCR both. And Bank Nifty to Nifty ratio is 1.93. And that also becoming bottom out. So there is good chance that we can see the good reversal point also for Bank Nifty. So be careful with the Bank Nifty shorts, because hedging also is very costly, because after a big move on the downside, it is buying a put option for hedge also is very very costly. And coming to Lakshman Tracker, definitely we are trailing stop loss we triggered, and 15 points below trailing stop loss, and 1000 points higher from trailing stop loss for Bank Nifty also. So enough cushion is there for Bank Nifty for reversal. We are comfortably sitting on 1700 points of profit in the Lakshman Rekha also. There is a good demand for puts in the Nifty, and in case of call, there is a demand for calls in the Bank Nifty. So IV is very high compared to the put option. And the moving averages, slightly we are around the 20 moving average, is not comfortably closing, but still we are slightly above the 20 moving average. Once this is broken, then 50 moving average will be next support. 11,200 will be next target, immediate target for Nifty. But in case of Bank Nifty, we are have a lot of resistance support at 20 moving average, 50 moving average. So there is less chance of Bank Nifty being, all the moves are getting sold off actually. So even the Nifty, Bank Nifty, the P ratio is giving a big divergence. P ratio for Nifty 13.7 and Bank Nifty is 23.46. So every dips being bought and sold, there is a big divergence between the Bank Nifty. One day the open interest increased here, one day open interest increased here. It's everything being traded, the pattern is being happening in the market now. And today if you see the weekly midpoint, what happened here is, in case of a Bank Nifty, we opened above the midpoint and then closed below midpoint. The reversal, 15% of trades, I told you that there will be reversal happening. That reversal happened today in this week for Bank Nifty. But in case of Nifty, we opened above the midpoint and sustained, closed above the midpoint also. So it is a bullish move. So 11,339 is the level you need to continuously monitor. In case we close below this, then it could be a big negative for Nifty, that can pull the Nifty to 11,200 levels easily. But we need to wait for the global clues also. Once Dow Jones started moving in a big way on downside, in no time, without giving any time for the chance for the base to take position, it can pull down the markets. And also you have seen that lot of puts are being built up by the retail clients. 1,19,000 contracts puts are being sold. Once these people also start squaring off the position, the downside can be very very sharp also. So just be have a note of this, cautious above this figure, what you can see in the client's position. So coming to the levels, long breakout 11,550 levels and short breakout 11,356 levels. And this is the camera law pivot points level actually for futures, based on futures. And you can just Google it also, you can get a camera law pivot points, update your high, low and close, and you will get these levels. So long breakout 22,583 and short breakout 21,796. So plot these levels, go long, go short, and once it goes below, then target for this also possible. So tomorrow like 22,000 should be support and should be, we'll be holding 22,000 levels in case of Bank Nifty. I don't expect 22,000 levels to be broken tomorrow. And similarly, here also 11,350, 11,400 should be a good support for Nifty, and not expecting that should be broken tomorrow. And coming to the learning point, since I'm not getting enough likes, I'm assuming that you're not interested in learning new things. So I'm not making any new learning video today. If you're interested, I will know that you want to know, learn new things from your likes. Okay. Hope you like the video. Please subscribe, like the channel so that I can continue. If you're interested in learning, I have no problems. It is all up to you. Okay. Thank you so much. Have a nice trading and profitable day.